Thank you for joining us today. I'm Rudy Stebbe, and welcome to Episode 12, Upgrading Windows XP to Windows 7, Part 2, here on HelpDesk TV. In Part 1, we walked you through on how to back up your Windows XP file settings and data files to be transferred to your new Windows 7 PC. Once Windows 7 is installed and up to date, it's time to bring back those data files and settings. First, connect the external storage device to which you save the Easy Transfer file to, open the drive in Windows Explorer, and double-click on the file. Windows Easy Transfer will launch, open the file, and present you with a password entry screen. Did you remember the password you typed in Part 1? You'll need to enter it here, and then click Next. Windows Easy Transfer will open the file and then display the users that were backed up from your Windows XP machine. Clicking the checkmark box beside the user's name will determine whether to restore the data or not. As before, you can click the Customize button below a user's name to restore only a certain portion of data. Selecting the Advanced Options link at the bottom of the window provides some very important functionality, such as the ability to map a user account on the old XP-based PC with a differently named user account in Windows 7. Selecting the Map Drives tab at the top of the window allows you the option of mapping the contents of your old drive on the Windows XP-based PC to a new drive on the Windows 7 system. Select the appropriate users and then click Transfer. The data and settings will be transferred over. Once the transfer is complete, the wizard will provide a detailed transfer report and, more compelling, a program report that explains which of your old Windows XP applications have more modern equivalents. The report also lists applications that were installed on your old XP machine, along with links so that you can re-download and install them under Windows 7. And now you have it. Windows 7 now has all your old XP settings and data. After you close the wizard, you will be prompted to restart your computer. I hope you enjoyed today's HelpDesk TV. If you have a comment about this program, a question, or a shortcut you would like to share with me, send us an email message to feedback@helpdesktv.ca. Thanks for watching.